Let's debate tonight with Sudhanshu Trivedi of the BJP, Brajesh Kalapa of the Congress, Ashish Khaitan of the Aam Aadmi Party, Hartosh Singhbal, political editor of Caravan. And my first question is to Aarti Jairath, senior journalist who's with me here. Is this hypocritical of Arvind Kejriwal?
Look, Arnab, he's clearly trapped in an image that he has carefully
crafted. Is it hypocritical?
Well, you know, I just want to know one thing. Is an Aam Aadmi not allowed to travel business class? Is that a problem? I mean, if somebody gives a free ticket to an Aam Aadmi, should he say, no, I'm Aam Aadmi, business class is only for Khas Aadmi, and therefore I should not travel?
Okay, so
I mean,
nothing
is that
wrong.
Nothing wrong. Yeah, I mean, if you're getting a free ticket, what's wrong with it?
And why
shouldn't an Aam Aadmi travel business
Singhbal,
class?
I want to know why. It's like Mulayam Singh Yadav who says, this 80-foot cake on my birthday is not for me. It's for the Aam Aadmi who are going to eat it. This buggy that I have got down from London is not for me. It's because I'm trying to empower people. Are you saying that Arvind Kejriwal
is
flying business class on an Emirates flight? No, one second. On behalf of the Aam Aadmi, is that the argument? Is this hypocritical? Hartosh, is this hypocritical? Because Arvind's getting a lot of flack for this. What do you think?
Of course he should get flack. You create a certain atmospherics. You indulge in theatrics. When you're called to account, you have to perform according to the theatrics you put up for the country. Isn't it? I mean, when Shashi Tharoor calls it cattle class, there is criticism because he's looking down on this whole business of how Aam Aadmi fly actually. Now suddenly Mr. Kejriwal wants to fly business class and yet claim the Aam Aadmi mantle, at the same time preach and lecture everybody else on simplicity about spending, things like that, then you will be called to account. I don't think the question is whether everybody else does it or not. The problem is Kejriwal is doing it.
Okay, so we'll let one more voice come into the debate, and that's of Sudhanshu Trivedi, before we let the Aam Aadmi Party respond to it. Ladies and gentlemen, the point is that here is Arvind Kejriwal, and I want to make a small point here. Arvind Kejriwal is a man who has made a public show of traveling in a metro to his swearing-in. He makes a public show of it. He's made a public show of taking an auto from the airport to the train station in Mumbai and then travels by local train to try and cultivate an image of someone who is one with the masses. So the question is, now he's taking political capital of this. He goes to a radio station, Radio Mirchi, just the other day, and says that, you know, I never even took a big car when I went for my inauguration there. I went in my Wagoner. Look at me, I'm the Aam Aadmi. So the question tonight will be, are you the Aam Aadmi only when people are not looking? So when you're traveling abroad, or when you get the opportunity, you fly by private jet. It's the hypocrisy we are talking about tonight. Sudhanshu Trivedi, what do you think? Sudhanshu Trivedi ji, aap kya kehna chahenge?
Actually, I agree with what Aarti Jairath had said. There is nothing wrong in travelling in the first class or business class or whatever it is. But it is a different standard of benchmarks with the parties set for themselves. As you have quoted now, that if Mulayam Singh is saying 80-foot cake is okay, I would also like to remind Mayawati, wearing a garland of currency notes, she says it's okay. So you set up your benchmark. It is not BJP or Congress or anybody has started. You just gave the example of Arvind Kejriwal coming for swearing in the metro. He says that their ministers will use the government vehicle only for the government cause, not in the private cause. I would like to ask, is going to take the swearing in of a minister is a private thing? It was a government function. You are going to take the charge as a government functionary. Then why you are making unnecessary this an issue? And particularly when you were the income tax commissioner and your wife both were availing the house which was entitled in your category. But when you become chief minister, you try to create a confusion or some sort of, you can say, gimmick.
Yeah.
And it shows just a immaturity. As you are graduating in the politics, you realize the ground realities. I would also like to remind, you remember the incidents when he was in Ahmedabad, then he took a chartered flight of a corporate house to first he dropped in Jaipur, he has performed a program and then reached in a media house program in Delhi. Because when you go...
Factually incorrect. We never took the chartered aircraft of any corporate house. We flew in the chartered aircraft provided by India Today Group from Jaipur to Delhi. Get your facts right. And I challenge you to That's prove that we I ever took saying. A chartered aircraft you are, of a corporate you house. You fly in the chartered aircrafts of Adani. We don't. Like prove it. I'm challenging you. You have just uttered a lie. You have just uttered a lie. A falsehood. I'm challenging you to prove this falsehood. Sudhanshu, otherwise all that you said just now is false. I'm challenging you to prove this falsehood. That we ever took the chartered aircraft of a corporate from Ahmedabad to Jaipur. Prove it.
But did he go on a business
class?
Did he go business class?
Otherwise, everything that you
say taken the
is
corporate
false.
Aircraft of India
everything
today.
Everything that you
so
say
you have
is
directly
a falsehood.
Been obliged
That's
by
what you are good at. Propaganda.
By a media house.
Propaganda. You are a propagandist.
It is better
you
that the party would have paid for that.
Everything
instead
that you
of
have
you yourself
said that
is saying
this,
that the media house
I
provided.
Debate on this point. You prove that we have ever taken the chartered aircraft of any
You should not have taken obligation of any of the media house.
I am challenging you.
You
the nation is watching you. Prove it.
Chetan, you have accepted that
Prove
you
it.
Have.
You are exposed.
You got into the
your
aircraft.
Your falsehood is exposed. Now let me complete. Now let me come in.
Your falsehood is.
You have had your say.
You taken the aircraft of India today. Why you have taken obligation of a media house?
No, watch it. Before you come in, he also. You came in. No, you came in without invitation at this time on opening remarks. Rajesh Kalapa was taking. Now, 1 second. At the core of Arvind Kejriwal's carefully crafted image, Ashish Khetan is the image of a man who doesn't like this VIP culture, who doesn't like this. And you know, when he flew on a private jet for a media event.
Will you give me the opportunity to.
Will you give me the opportunity to ask you? No, but will you let me the opportunity to ask you? Because
yeah, yeah.
You see,
have been asking for the first 10 minutes.
When
yes.
he flew on a private jet for a media event and he flew on a private
yes.
jet, what was his defense?
I'll tell
Arvind
you.
Kejriwal's defense. No, I remember. I have a very strong memory on these things.
Yeah, yeah. So
he defended himself. Thank you. So do I. He defended himself saying that there was no regular flight available. 1 second, right? There was no regular flight available, so the India Today group hired a chartered plane for him.
Right.
Now, today, there is a whole plane sitting in economy behind
right.
him. There must be about 200 people sitting
Absolutely.
In economy behind him. What
Absolutely.
Is his excuse now?
Now,
give
I'll
me the
tell
excuse.
You. Now, I'll tell you.
No, tell give me the excuse.
Yeah, and
no,
there's no
the
excuse. We are not here to give an excuse.
Well, you
Hamare
have to give an excuse.
Aam aadmi ki paribhasha kya hai? जो व्यक्ति ईमानदार और स्वस्थ व्यवस्था में विश्वास रखता है वो आम आदमी है चाहे वो पूंजीपति हो चाहे वो मिडिल क्लास हो चाहे वो अर्णव गोस्वामी हो चाहे आशीष खेतान हो और जो व्यक्ति बेईमान व्यवस्था में विश्वास रखता है और बेईमान व्यवस्था इस देश में चाहता है
मैं एक बाइट प्ले कर देता हूँ
वो खास आदमी
मैं एक बाइट प्ले कर देता हूँ
आप कर दीजिए
और आपको भी टीवी पे रखूंगा एक मिनट
यू हैव टू बी फेयर अर्णव गोस्वामी You posed questions for the first 10 minutes. You have set up the stage. You cannot move on with the debate without giving me the opportunity to retort.
I want to remind you. Let me play a soundbite. Ashish Khetan.
You have played the soundbite.
Ashish Khetan, I have not played the whole soundbite.
This is not
I will give you your full opportunity.
This is not a fair debate. You have made four people intervene. Who are speaking
so,
against
so
us.
So I'm saying something here.
Give me the opportunity.
Watch. First of all, she was
give
not speaking
minute.
Against you. No, watch.
Give me 1 minute.
No, Ashish, give me one minute.
Okay,
you give me half a minute before. I will give you 2 minutes, but before that, I will play a sound.
Okay.
Now, 1 second.
Fair
so that's the arrangement.
Okay.
Fine. I will give you 2 minutes to reply. Rajesh Kalapa of the Congress hasn't spoken. But ladies and gentlemen, you see, on the 3rd of December, I heard this on radio. Arvind Kejriwal says how I was chief minister. And I was chief minister, I don't like big cars, I don't like this. And I take my Wagon R, I go on the streets, I roll down. I want to be with the people. Now, at that time, he didn't say that I behave like this when I'm in Delhi, but when somebody gives me a business class ticket or when they give me a private jet, I happily get into it. Because in both cases, what comes across is that when nobody is looking, you have a completely different attitude.
We are flying in a commercial airliner. Everybody is looking. It's not a stealth aircraft that
so
nobody is looking.
No, but just listen to this sound.
He's
right
checking
now.
In. He's
listen
boarding the aircraft.
Yeah.
He's so sitting in full public
no, no, then
view.
You don't make comments
this
like this
that
one.
Nobody is looking.
Then you don't make
if
comments like
looking,
this one.
How
Here's
this,
the comment.
How did this picture come
we
in
keep,
public
We'll
domain?
Keep Ashish Khetan on the screen and play the sound bite.
Everybody is looking.
Ashish.
I dropped him to the airport.
Ashish, first look at this. Look at this sound bite.
Yeah.
Listen to it.
Yeah.
नहीं मैं बिल्कुल आम आदमी हूँ और इनफैक्ट पॉलिटिक्स में आने के बाद भी सीएम बनने के बाद भी मैं आम आदमी की ज़िंदगी जैसे एक छोटा सा एग्जांपल देता हूँ मैं आपको जब मैं सीएम बना तो इन्होंने बड़ी गाड़ी भेजी मेरे लिए और लाल बत्ती वाली गाड़ी भेजी मैंने कहा नहीं मेरे को सरकारी गाड़ी नहीं चाहिए मैं अपनी वैगनआर टूटी फूटी मेरी वैगनआर होती थी मैं उसी में चलूंगा तो मैं जाया करता था रेड लाइट पे फिर मैंने सिक्योरिटी भी नहीं ली नहीं तो रेड लाइट तो होती नहीं मुख्यमंत्री के लिए तो मैं रेड लाइट पे रुकता था तो बहुत सारे लोग देखा करते थे, आ जाते थे मेरी रेड लाइट में, शीशा नीचे करता था, लोग हाथ मिलाते थे। लोगों को विश्वास नहीं होता था कि मुख्यमंत्री से ऐसे रेड लाइट पे हाथ देके उसकी गाड़ी रोकी जा सकती है, उससे हाथ मिलाया जा सकता है। सो आम आदमी हूँ, आम आदमी रहना चाहता हूँ।
बड़ी गाड़ी भेजी मगर मैंने टूटी फूटी अपनी वैगन आर में मैं गया तो इधर भी आप कह सकते थे आपने हमें प्राइवेट जेट भेजा और मगर मैं प्राइवेट जेट में नहीं जाता हूँ, मैं आम आदमी हूँ, मैं अपने इकोनॉमी क्लास में जाऊंगा या इकोनॉमी फ्लाइट में जाऊंगा, तो व्हाई डज द सेम लॉजिक नॉट अप्लाई?
नो, बिकॉज़ गिव मी 2 मिनट्स,
नो यू विल रिप्लाई एंड देन ही विल यू हैव, ही हैज टू स्पीक टू यू,
यू विल गिव मी अनइंटरप्टेड 2 मिनट्स,
डोंट बी ऑन द डिफेंसिव
आशीष, नो आई एम नॉट ऑन द डिफेंसिव, आई एम एंजॉयिंग दिस,
थैंक यू वेरी मच,
आई एम एक्चुअली ग्लैड दैट यू आर हैविंग दिस डिबेट। Tell you
that's
why.
All right. Everybody who's in
I'll
a trouble spot says
if tomorrow
that.
Again we get a
private
government
jet?
Vehicle, listen to me. If it tomorrow again we get a government vehicle with a lal batti on top of it, we won't take it because we don't want to inconvenience the common man. We don't want to put burden on the exchequer. But at the same time,
serious.
If tomorrow Arnab Goswami, you flew us in business class 2 years ago to your event in Kolkata.
No, I'll tell you what.
I'll tell you what. We'll again
You check.
We will again.
One second. I'll make my position.
You have broken
clear.
Your promise. You said you'll give me
uninterrupted
2 minutes.
Because I must clarify.
That
I must
shows,
clarify. You ask Arvind Kejriwal that question.
That don't believe in a fair debate.
No. One second.
I don't want others to make their point.
I'll tell you something.
No, let me complete my point then.
Listen to me. When we ask Arvind Kejriwal to come to Kolkata.
Why don't you listen to me?
So that you, when we ask Arvind Kejriwal to come to Kolkata, we offered him a business class ticket. Arvind Kejriwal says, no, I would flight to fly economy and he flew economy, so that was Arvind Kejriwal 2 years back,
okay.
And this is Arvind Kejriwal now, okay. Now I'll answer first
you,
of all
you clear. Put us in a 5-star hotel, that's correct or not?
Yeah. So I'm not telling
No, listen to me. See, there's a big difference between getting an invitation from Arnab Goswami's Times Now or India Today Group and you are sending us a chartered aircraft or a
If you send a chartered aircraft,
if there is no other commercial airline in that time
saying,
slot,
Karvi?
We'll take that chartered aircraft.
The point is, we are against
the VIP culture, which puts a big burden
exactly
on the common man. We are against that VIP culture.
So you see.
No, today, what is the debate? I'll tell you one thing.
The debate is...
Uninterrupted 30 seconds.
I've given you 2 minutes.
You promised 2 minutes, give me 30 seconds.
You're in a spot, Baba.
I am in a spot, I'm the dog. Give me 30 seconds.
I know you're in the spot. You know you're in the spot.
That's your conclusion. Give me 30 seconds. We don't see any conflict between being wealthy, between being living a comfortable life, and being honest.
Now
we are all aspirational. We don't believe in class divisions. Aam Aadmi doesn't mean
what
that Aam Aadmi will not live a comfortable life. I have come from middle class.
People are watching TV now.
All those who
people
make Aam Aadmi Party
people
are
watching some television pe dekh rahe hain, soch
or lower class. There is no conflict between being rich, between being middle class, between being an aspirational class, and between being an arm army.
You have to understand, I too
want to give a comfortable life to my family. I will take an invitation.
You go on a private jet.
I will get into a private jet if there is no other arrangement. If I have to attend an event, I will go into a private jet.
But the private jet
is not offered by somebody who has a conflict of interest.
Okay,
who has a conflict of interest with my functioning.
So today,
Adani's private jet has a conflict of interest with Narendra Modi's government's functioning. That's why it's a problem. But the private jet provided by India Today Group has no conflict.
Ashish Khetan, a minute.
The functioning of Aam Aadmi Party.
Ashish, now,
we will take the private Today group,
one second.
But we won't take that private jet of Adani, of Ambani. That's why we take donations from Aam Aadmi, from middle class. We don't take donations from corporations like Adani and Ambani.
You see now, Ashish, can you close
no,
please?
No,
because I have to let others in.
No, you let others in. But you allow me to complete my point.
I'm telling you here tonight, one second. You see, please, Brajesh will come in.
Let Brajesh come in.
You see, now one second. So what you're basically saying is, his basic argument is, Aam Aadmi is not literal. It is a philosophy. It's a philosophical situation.
It's a state of mind.
Exactly. Now, I don't want to
say... It's an article of faith.
Right. It's like a BJP
faith in honesty.
Hindutva is
faith
not a political a slogan. Hindutva is a state of mind. My question...
Yes. Let them admit that it's a state of mind for them.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight the Aam Aadmi Party says... Being Aam Aadmi is a state of mind. This is going to be one of the quotable quotes of the year. And my point is, in your political campaigns, you have carefully tried repeatedly to adopt a literal image of the Aam Aadmi. mark my words, not a metaphorical one. So you can't turn around and say it's a metaphorical.
I'm sorry to say that. We have the visual metaphor of Infosys CEO V. Balakrishnan being an Aam Aadmi. We have the visual metaphor of several other corporate honchos who joined Aam Aadmi Party.
Brajesh wants to counter you.
We have the visual metaphor of the creme de la creme who supported Aam Aadmi Party. We have the visual metaphor of making a speech in Columbia University on the 7th of this month.
Why did he symbolically...
That's the visual metaphor.
One second. Why did he symbolically take the... Please just...
I'll tell you.
The point
I am wearing a 5,000 rupees pullover. That's the visual metaphor. I am wearing a 5,000 rupees pullover. That's the visual metaphor.
And I bought it with my honest money.
After paying tax. That's the visual metaphor. I am wearing a 5,000 rupees shirt. That's the visual metaphor. Yeah, 5,000 rupees.
So you are wearing 5,000
yes,
rupees shirt.
Yes, that's the visual metaphor. Because when I was working as a journalist, I was taking home a salary of 3 lakhs per month.
Okay.
Yes. So today I can't afford it because I've joined Aam Aadmi Party. I've not earned
my
a single penny for the last 1 year. Today I can't afford it.
Current logic.
So I'm saying, if you want to see visual metaphor,
ladies and gentlemen,
we have the visual metaphor.
May I please? Wearing tattered clothes because Aam Aadmi only wears tattered clothes.
Aam Aadmi Party, as I said, is a state of mind. Aam Aadmi Party doesn't mean what you wear. No. Aam Aadmi Party means
Ashish,
what you do.
Now
that's Aam Aadmi Party.
Ashish,
what you intend to do, that's Aam Aadmi Party.
Ashish, can you now let other Aam Aadmi must also let others speak. You see, I'm saying one thing.
Let me
complete
25 minutes later, Arnab. No, I'm sure you'll appreciate that Aam Aadmi was really the Congress Party slogan. They stole it. Right? And the least you can do is 25 minutes later, allow me an opportunity
to
speak.
Because you pleased Aam Aadmi.
Please.
You became a party of corporates.
No, please. I didn't interrupt.
Let him speak.
You see, let's go by it, you know, from date by date, right? This gentleman becomes chief minister. Then he says that, no, I'm not going to stay in my old house. I'm going to move into some kind of place which is close by to Delhi. And then comes and settles himself in a accommodation which is, you know, put together cumulatively much larger than the house of the chief minister of Delhi, whom he says that, you know, she was living in a very luxurious manner, and this is, you know, something which was totally unacceptable. Yes. Then there is a media outcry and says, no, I'm shifting from this place, I'm moving to another place, stays in that place. Then what happens to his wagoner? While he's chief minister, suddenly dumps it, suddenly starts using the government car.
So what are you saying?
No, the point is...
This is a marketing gimmick.
Look, it's all dramatics. It's dramatics for a person who's an absolute opportunist. Absolute opportunist. You see, you have to understand that this is the very same person who overstays his stay in governmental accommodation. He stays for beyond some 7-8 months. Who pays his rent? Who pays this rent? And what is the big show about? You know, in the first place, you say, I'm not going to move out of my Ghaziabad residence. Move into a massive bungalow. And then you say, no, I'm not going to use my governmental car. Use your governmental car.
So the point
is... every rule he has made, he has broken.
The point is that you cultivate an image to get political brownie points. And you say that I could have taken a helicopter to fly between offices and the residence, but if I could have said I'm an efficient chief minister, but I did not do that, I went in my wagoner. That's not one point. The point is... in Mumbai in March this year, a lot of people were inconvenienced because Arvind Kejriwal made a very public spectacle of his Aam Aadmi Party credentials by taking an auto rickshaw from Santa Cruz Airport, then climbing onto a train from Churchgate Station. I can give you, and all of these are, you know, now it's becoming a little. On January 3rd this
today
year.
Today, when Prime Minister moves in the city, the whole traffic comes to a grinding halt for 6 hours.
I'm asking you.
The city goes for a toss.
I'm asking you, you see, he's asking you about...
Doesn't that qualify as inconvenience for you?
I'll tell you three U-turns. And we have a right to ask these questions. Don't be like the politicians who can't ask questions. Listen to the question.
I'm not a politician.
No, you are a politician.
No, I'm not a politician.
Very much a politician.
I'm not a politician.
You say Aam Aadmi Party politician.
We are not politicians. Because
what are you?
We are a happy party.
You're a happy party.
We believe in likable politics. I'm a likable politician.
You're a likable politician.
I'm a middle class likable politician. But I'm not just a politician. Don't say that I'm just a politician. No, I'm a likable politician.
I'm a likable politician.
And I come from a happy party.
No, nobody.
I'm not cribbing about bangla, gali. They are cribbing about. Why did we used to move around a wagon? No, I'll tell you why.
Ashish,
one line.
No,
one line.
You have.
You know, because we want to be accessible. accessible to the common man.
Okay.
We want to give the message that no, we are among you.
So you go,
we are not a distant
then
dream.
Then travel economy.
Like
why?
Modi is,
no,
like Rahul Gandhi is.
Rahul
Gandhi
and
Modi are distant dreams. We live among common
Ashish,
people.
Ashish,
that's
please.
My viewpoint.
Ashish, just a minute. Just a minute. Appreciate everything. I appreciate what you're saying. You are saying that we want to come closer to the Aam Aadmi, which
absolutely.
Is why whenever we get an opportunity, we go on a private jet or we'll travel business class. Maybe it is a new way to get closer to the Aam Aadmi.
We are as traveling in a local train as
sure.
we are traveling in a business class.
I am
that's the viewpoint.
Absolutely.
Have you ever seen Modi ji traveling in a local train in Mumbai? Ever seen Modi ji stopping at a traffic signal? Tell
the,
me.
The
tell
public
me.
Show.
Modi,
Ashish,
Rahul Gandhi, Sonia Gandhi are distant
Ashish,
dreams.
Ashish, a minute, please. See,
we are intimate,
Ashish,
proximate
Ashish,
to the
Ashish,
common
a minute.
Man.
Ashish.
We live among them.
Ashish, just a minute, please.
We are like them.
Ashish, you are the only party. No, no, one second. You are the only party. You are the only party. I'd like to remind you. How many U-turns? One second. And Ashish, just listen, please. How many U-turns will you make?
Arnab, I think.
How many U-turns will you make? You are also the only party. You have a vision document. And you put it in the vision document that we will, as all people and members of the Aam Aadmi Party, shun luxuries.
Hmm.
Flying in a private jet is not a necessity. Today you are saying
we shun luxuries. We shun luxuries at the cost of government exchequer. Today,
you forgot
we
point
the
number
ex-CEO
four.
Of Infosys
how many
as a member of Aam Aadmi Party. Can we stop him from flying in business class?
No, what's it? What you said?
We have Meera Sanyal.
So what happens to your vision document?
Of Royal Bank of Scotland.
What happens to your vision document?
She goes on expensive holidays.
What is going on, Ashish?
If we can afford luxuries through our honest means, we'll afford it.
Okay.
But we'll not put the burden of our luxuries on the government exchequer,
okay, so
on the common man.
Why
didn't
you?
Suppose
somebody asks you a simple question.
That's a philosophy.
One second. So, ye Hindi mein jaise log kahenge, mauka mile to private jet.
Ji nahi.
Sun lijiye meri baat.
Haan.
Mauka mile to private jet, waise aam aadmi. दूसरी बात ये लोग कहेंगे, मेरी बात सुनिए आशीष,
चाहे कमरे के अंदर हो चाहे कमरे के बाहर,
लोग इस बात को कहेंगे,
कोई भी हो, हम हैं आम आदमी, हम प्राइवेट जेट में भी आम आदमी है, लोकल ट्रेन में भी आम आदमी है, और कमर्शियल एयरलाइन में भी आम आदमी है,
why don't you take that money and Sudhanshu Trivedi is coming in and Brajesh Kalappa, why don't you take the money and give it to poor people who you say you represent? You are the ones who made a public image that we are different, we have a vision
document. ये 20,000 रुपए का एहतियात के टिकट से आम आदमी का क्या भला हो जाएगा? पब्लिक का पैसा जो कांग्रेस और बीजेपी वाले लूट रहे हैं उसको तो बचाना है पहले।
आप लोगों
का बजट है देश का हर साल जो लूट में चला जाता है।
सो नाउ द आर्गुमेंट, नाउ इट्स अनदर आर्गुमेंट।
आप 20,000 रुपए के टिकट से देश का भला कर देंगे?
आशीष सुन लीजिए,
नहीं आप 20,000 रुपए के टिकट से देश का भला कर देंगे?
आशीष जी, लोगों की बात सुनिए,
मेरी बात सुनिए,
20,000 नहीं था वो 1,00,000,
20,000 रुपए से देश का भला होगा?
आशीष,
एक आदमी ने 20,000 रुपए के टिकट भेजा, आप कह रहे हैं कि उस टिकट को बेच
आशीष,
तो
आशीष,
आदमी को दे दो।
No, I don't want to raise my voice. I'm just saying one.
No, don't raise it. Your voice is already raised.
My point is simply this, that if every 2 minutes you change your position, it's not looking good. And now what you are saying is that don't ask me questions because I'm whatever is a little less money. The money being spent is by others. Somebody will ask you, are you traveling private jets and business class to save the people of this country? You see, you're on a very thin line and it's not going to work. I want Sudhanshu Trivedi to have a word. Sudhanshu Trivedi. To the BJP, to the Aam Aadmi Party.
Yes.
Columbia University.
Listen.
Their definition of luxury and the modesty is such a privilege that I would like to remind. अरे भाई अब मुझे बोलने दीजिए, यू हैव टेकन मच मोर देन द टाइम विच वॉज एंटाइटल्ड,
गो अहेड,
बोलिए साहब, बोलिए आप ही का सवाल।
नो, आई वुड लाइक टू रिमाइंड द पीपल दैट व्हेन दे वर प्रोवाइडेड द गवर्नमेंट कार विच वर द एम्बेसडर, दे सेड दे विल नॉट इन ट्राई टू हैव अ लग्जरी, देन ऑल देयर मिनिस्टर्स बॉट एन इनोवा कार विच इज मोर लग्जरियस देन एम्बेसडर, ट्वाइस द कॉस्ट, and the Innova is of a foreign company and ambassador an Indian company. This is their definition of luxury.
I just want to ask you, in your program,
Arvind Kejriwal, he was saying
Modi travels abroad.
People have seen a chief minister on a red light, they can have a handshake. But in a plane, he doesn't want to sit in a cattle class to have a handshake. He wants to be in the first class. Now, on the other aspect of so-called tam-jham of politicians, security is also a matter of concern. There were so many unfortunate events of slapping Arvind Kejriwal, which Aam Aadmi Party has come, that these were the saline people. Can the senile people or these type of unoriented people be allowed to disturb or insult the first citizen of a state? No. So that's why I'm saying, be realistic. Then you should be able to understand what is the importance of security.
Ashish, it's not right to always interrupt. No, you let him finish.
And what the other things like luxury and modesty and other things, I am just listening to your ridiculous statement for so many times. You were saying that you were having a 3 lakh salary and you are not doing anything CSR. If the corporate worlds are saying to have a CSR, then it is incumbent on the part of those who are having the luxurious life. It cannot only be when you become politician, then you become very good. Otherwise, you are
the question is about this counter question.
Similarly, all incoherent.
Arvind Kejriwal and now your
CSR, my salary.
Counter question is coming in from Rajesh Kalappa. Ashish Khetan, the question is not this. Okay. You please understand
you
the
basic. You want to gag me, I will sit quiet.
Ashish, if you think that after going on and taking 80% of the time on the program, anyone's trying to gag
you,
then you've got that wrong as well. Now,
we're all sitting here.
Let me come in now, please.
No, the question is, who created the image? One second. Did anybody create this image for Arvind Kejriwal? Did anybody tell him to cultivate this image of somebody who, you know, who would not do all the things? He almost put out an image saying, I am the person who leads this ascetic kind of life. And the number of U-turns which he has done, which I just want to place before Rajesh takes it out. There's a U-turn on the bungalow. Then there are repeated questions on Rahul Gandhi, Narendra Modi's use of private jets and then flying one himself. The U-turn on government cars. I mean, there are innumerable, and now this situation where he's regularly seen now, he's now flying business class and the argument is being made, he's not flying business class himself, he's flying on behalf of the people. So what if he does? And, you know, this is the whole concept of an Aam Aadmi is not a literal one, it's a philosophical and metaphorical one. Go try telling the people of Delhi. Try telling the people of Delhi this, Ashish Khetan, ki jo, no. Aap kahiye ki Aam Aadmi soch mein hai. सोच विचार में है हम जो कपड़े पहनते हैं रेडियो स्टेशन में जो बोलते हैं उसकी विश्वास मत कीजिए हम जो पीछे पर्दे जो करते हैं प्राइवेट जेट में जो करते हैं जब बाहर जाते हैं उसको भी लोग मानेंगे लोग आपको कहेंगे वर यू रियल वर यू ऑनेस्ट और वर यू जस्ट वन बिग अलाउ मी टू कंप्लीट वर यू वन बिग जाइगेंटिक वेल क्राफ्टेड मार्केटिंग गिमिक Tell because me, Arnab, you have your words have to match your actions.
For you, this Arnab, talk about fighting against corruption.
It's a matter
maybe
of timing.
Maybe just a profession.
Mr. Khetan,
for you, the fight against corruption may be just Arnab. A profession. It's a mission for us. You are sitting on your comfortable job in your cushy chair. We have sacrificed everything.
Really? So let me ask you.
I have not got a penny in my bank account in the last 1.5 years.
Okay, so Mr.
Tell me. Mr. Can you live without a salary for 1.5 years?
Ashish Khetan, I'm not.
I'll tell you one thing. For us, it's a mission. It's a mission that we have set out on.
Ashish, listen.
For us, fight against corruption is a mission.
Ashish, I'll tell you.
I tell you, go and tell the people of Delhi that have we indulged in any scam? Have we fleeced the public? Have we not fought against corruption of Congress party? Have we not fought against the corruption of BJP and MCD?
That doesn't give you the right to gag us all on this TV show.
I think there's a very simple reply. When he finishes, I will reply.
Who fought the fight against black money? Who was in the street?
It's a matter of timing.
Who fought the fight against corruption?
Ashish, now let them speak.
It's a matter of timing. Just the other day we saw Mr. Kejriwal going around from table to table collecting money, 20,000 rupees from each diner. Now, if he were really serious about collecting money, the first thing he would have done is he would have flown economy.
Let him speak.
He would have flown economy because a business class ticket costs four times more than how much an economic class ticket costs. The first thing he would have done, if he were serious about collecting funds, he's seen that this, you know, the difference amount goes to the party. If he were serious about collecting funds. The second issue is, now, Mr. Trivedi, of course, is saying whatever he's saying about the wagon. But I don't know if his own Prime Minister, who promised to go around in a Scorpio, is aware that he's traveling in a BMW nowadays. I don't know if he... And in so far
he's the Prime Minister of India.
No, that's okay. That's okay. But he promised. He made a promise. Just like Arvind Kejriwal promised to go on his wagon hour, he made a promise. The Prime Minister of India made a promise that he'd travel on a Scorpio.
No, once, who's made political capital of cultivating the image of an Aam Aadmi?
Who has given a call? Ashish, to Spain, to America.
You prove one of these trips to me. Each trip, you prove one trip to me. Just now you are asking for proof. Now you don't want to give any proof. You are supposed to be a former journalist. The least you can do is provide some basic proof.
Ashish, don't speak over others. I'm requesting you, Ashish. Don't speak over others. And one thing, I'll just make a point, small point. You know, Ashish, I don't like these kind of lectures on journalism, because you can go and do some searches yourself. Where was the Aam Aadmi Party when the CWG scam was broken? Where was the Aam Aadmi Party when the 2G scam was broken? Where was the Aam Aadmi Party when the Devas ISRO scam was broken? When the Aircel Maxis scam was broken? Where was the Aam Aadmi Party when the Adarsh scam was broken?
I broke the Aircel Maxis story.
The Aircel Maxis story was broken in the entire media. Anyway, the question is, there was no Aam Aadmi Party at that point of time. Predominantly, all these stories that you have made political capital on quite effectively are stories that have been covered by the media. So you should watch yourself when you make these sweeping statements. Doing it for my profession. I do it for my profession. I don't seek to become a politician out of it. There are some journalists, Ashish, who do it as their profession and then also want to make political capital out of it.
I have quit my profession.
And therefore,
to take a plunge in politics.
I think that was just to put your question in its place.
I'll tell you, you have to walk the talk. You have to walk the talk. I wish you could have changed the country.
People who are
80% of BJP funding is black money. 75% of Congress funding is black money. TV debate stop the splurge of 30,000 crore rupees in Lok Sabha elections? Did your TV debate stop the splurge of 5,000 crore rupees in Maharashtra elections? Did your TV debate bring back the black money from Switzerland? Did your TV debate stop the 2G scam? Stop the CWG scam.
So why are you on a TV debate?
You have to change the system.
No, then why are you on a TV debate?
And if the only way you can change the system
then everyone
is by getting into the system.
No, Ashish, you know something.
And I'm not saying that. Everybody has to make personal sacrifices.
I'd like to get Hartosh into the debate.
But don't ridicule me for making that choice.
Don't
ridicule me.
Don't
mock me for making that choice.
I'm just putting you in your place.
I'm telling you. I'm making great personal sacrifice.
So I'm putting
don't
your
mock
choice.
Me for
it's
making that
choice.
Sacrifice.
You to become a politician is your choice.
No, that's my choice, but don't mock me.
You are
don't
a politician.
Ridicule me.
But you are a politician.
No, don't ridicule
but
me.
You are a politician.
That I'm Aam Aadmi.
But you are a politician.
I'm an honest politician. Yes, if you call me a politician, I'm honest politician.
But again,
I talk about honesty.
1 second, please, Ashish. Ashish, you have Aarti Chairat, just stop, please.
We are honest journalists here. We also make
them. 1 second, Ashish, let others speak. Let Aarti speak. Let Aarti speak.
It's not about honest journalism, it's honest politics. The debate is not about honest journalism.
Ashish, will you
No, but that's what you're making it into. That's what you're making it into. And you know, we practice. It's our profession
Ashish, have some respect. Have some respect for the other panelists.
Because we believe
this debate about
we want the honest, good government for this country. And that's what we do as good journalists. So I'm sorry, don't give
this
us
debate,
lectures.
Let's
don't
stick
give
to
us
the point.
Lectures.
No, I think you are going off the tangent.
Actually, you have ended up trivializing politics completely.
I'm saying that to become a politician, you have to make personal sacrifices. We have decided
you
to walk the talk.
You are doing a disservice to the people of Delhi.
We have put our
so
life on the line.
The
we have put
party.
Our families on the line.
No,
we
sorry.
Have put our kids on the
you
line.
Have done
you know that
it's your choice.
You know that.
It's
so
your
don't
choice.
Mock my choice.
It's your choice.
Don't, you know
relax.
How I paid my fees for the kids over the last 3 months.
It's your choice.
Don't mock me.
Don't mock my honesty. Don't mock my honesty. Don't mock my honesty. Don't say that only you are the one who's carrying the mantle.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Adnab. I must come into this. I must come into this, when he says that he's an honest politician, doesn't mean I'm not an honest politician.
Have the patience to listen to
others. Doesn't mean that I'm not an honest politician. Of course I'm an honest politician. I practice my profession and I work very hard to do what I'm doing now. Am I an honest or a dishonest politician? What kind of rubbish is this?
You belong to say that I'm a dishonest party.
Politician. You are a dishonest party. Everything you do is dishonest. This is not correct. Of course, I'm an honest politician. You name damn one thing where I've made money. This is not correct.
A party of Robert
Baden. I don't like this.
A party of Robert Baden.
If you've made sacrifices, I've made enough and more sacrifices.
The party is the most dishonest party.
You are a dishonest person to say that.
Okay.
No, we do our politics seriously.
The fact is,
name one case.
One second, gentlemen. No, one second. I request both sides to come down, including
this is not done.
My question to Hardcore Singh Bahl is this:
bad review coming from you, I'm not mine.
And Ashish Khaitan, you must have one value, which whether you're a journalist or politician, learn to listen for a change. My question is, and please listen. Yes, thank you. Now my question is to Hardcore. You see, what is the bottom line issue? And Hardcore, you must have thought, do I even exist in this debate? Well, I'm really sorry, but you can't blame me for this one. My question is very simply this. What are we debating tonight? Arvind Kejriwal, prisoner of his own image. I have three questions, Hardcore, to you. Who told Arvind Kejriwal to cultivate the image, and is it a cultivated image or not? B, have you taken political capital out of that image? C, if you have taken political capital of that image and you have made it your slogan, you have said, you've even put it in your vision document, if people now find you in certain situations transgressing the rules you set for yourself, should you get so angry or should you explain? I mean, you can get outraged, but then nobody told you to set these standards for yourself, and now when people are asking you questions, you appear to be extremely upset about it. What would you say to Ashish Khaitan, who's furious that anyone is asking him tonight? Hi, Arthosh.
Arnab, precisely the point. I think the debate has veered off onto irrelevancies, but we have to remember where the Aam Aadmi Party started. It started with a Gandhian movement. Imagery and symbolism are central to this. How would it have looked if Arvind Kejriwal would have flown to his hunger fast in a business class plane, the seat, or he travelled in a Volvo to the site of the fast? That imagery was relevant to the politics he was conducting. That is why questions are being asked. Was Gandhi a fool to be travelling around third class? Is that what Ashish Khaitan is implying? And Ashish Khaitan is making so much of being holier than thou, this preachiness. I'd love to give up my job and fly around in business class if that is the kind of sacrifice politics involves.
Okay, so this question
of imagery that they now try to dismiss is an imagery they've set up right for themselves. Gandhian beliefs, Gandhian thoughts is something they had forefronted right in front. Now they want to walk away from it, make a mockery of it, and try to divert it into all kinds of irrelevancies about everybody is an Aam Aadmi, Adani is an Aam Aadmi as well. So is the person on the street.
We are not supposed to take it. You mean all those who are flying in business class are dishonest people?
They are not flying. They are not going
they
to the... No, they are not taking, making a political campaign out of it.
Hotel
are not
making,
they are not making, they are not making political campaign out of it.
You think that we are living a life of luxury?
You are making the mockery of the very foundation on which you
I'm
started
you
into politics.
Invitation. Why don't you come and join the life of luxury then? If you think that being an Aam Aadmi is a life of luxury...
I am not interested in the kind of politics you are doing.
Sorry.
Hypocrisy
you
does not
some
suit
very
me,
Ashish. Comments. I never
then
make any personal
lecturing
comments.
Lecturing to people in the world is gambit of the hell.
Listen to his response.
You learned from there.
Ashish, now listen to his response. Listen to that response, Ashish. It can't be one way. Sudhanshu Trivedi is asking the question
the
here, and I request here. You
mean to say that we
there is
business class every day?
One second. Let others speak.
Like to say two sentences.
Is that an Aam Aadmi problem that nobody else can speak? Is that
if
what the Aam Aadmi
on record?
Does? I thought Aam Aadmi listens.
If the representative of a recognized political party by the Election Commission of India, which ruled the Delhi state for 49 days, is saying that I am not a politician, this shows their hypocrisy and interpretation of the constitutional terminology as per their own whims and fancies. And instead of going into the cacophony, which has already taken a lot, I would like to conclude with two line of phrases in Hindi. Abhi inko rajneeti mein aaye hue jumme jumme char din hue hain aur inki rangat wo hai ki reh rahe ke badalte hain din raat naye chole अंदर से बड़े जालिम बाहर से बड़े भोले. दिस समराइजेज द एंटायर एपिटोम ऑफ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ आम आदमी पार्टी विच आर ट्राइंग टू हुडविंक द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया सिंस लास्ट सेवरल इयर्स.
तुकबंदी मत करिए, तुकबंदी में बहुत चीजें निकल जाती हैं आप लोगों के मुंह से.
नाउ नाउ बिफोर इट बिफोर वी
डिस्कस दिस इज अ
फ्रेज. नो 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 वी आर क्लोजिंग दिस डिबेट एंड माय क्वेश्चन इज टुनाइट टू ऑल आवर व्यूअर्स.
ये हरामजादे
डियर व्यूअर्स, डू यू थिंक
बंदी कम करें जरा.
डू यू थिंक द आम आदमी पार्टी एंड केजरीवाल इज कॉट इन हिज ओन इमेज ट्रैप एंड हु टोल्ड हिम टू क्रिएट द इमेज फॉर योरसेल्फ. यू कैन ट्वीट ऑन दैट.
यू
हर्ड मी. आई डोंट रिपीट दिस काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज ऑन द प्रोग्राम. आई हैव टिल दिस डेट टिल दिस पॉइंट आशीष आई हैव नॉट यूज्ड दैट वर्ड ऑन द प्रोग्राम एंड आई विल नॉट अलाउ यू टू यूज इट ऑन द प्रोग्राम. You won't use it on the program. You will no, but I will not use that word. No, it is not a it's not a term. This is the times now, and you will not use this. You whatever. But you, this is a channel. On this channel, I won't let you use the word. On this channel, I won't let you use the word. That's it on the News Hour debate tonight. And I repeat, I take back the words which Ashish Khaitan has used. I don't approve of the use of such words, even if they are being repeated. Thank you for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.